So yeah, maybe goes in late in the game. It's better late in the game. So I'm gonna let you just say a few words.
Thank you, Adam, and thank you all for being here today. What a beautiful day. This is really a sign that we're doing the right thing here. So hemp is something that a lot of people are just learning about, the nutritional benefits of hemp. This is certified organic, this is non-GMO, and all of the companies that produce hemp products are very all about all of these things. They want to make sure people understand that this is not processed in any way. This is literally just the raw hemp seed. And that's what is so nutritionally benefit, not only for us, but also for the farmland. It doesn't require herbicides or pesticides. It's a very low input crop. So it's great for farmers, and it's great for our bodies. And current policies in the United States make it illegal for American farmers to grow hemp. And the FDA has not even certified this as generally recognized as safe. So that is the grass status. And hemp, they will not give hemp that status because American farmers can't grow it. And it's important that we learn about this, we purchase hemp products, we eat hemp products, and we talk about this so that we can change these laws, change these regulations, get the FDA and the USDA to help farmers and to help us become healthier people. And I work with Vote Hemp, and we are the advocacy group here in Washington, D.C., working to change those laws. So you can learn more at votehemp.com, and also I urge you to get involved with Hemp History, which is going to be held this summer, and it's a great way to talk about the history of hemp farming. This used to be right where there was hemp grown, right around this neighborhood. Actually, hemp used to be grown right in Arlington Farms, and So there's definitely ways to get involved. Hemp History Week is a way to learn about the history of hemp and the nutritional benefits of hemp as well. So thank you so much. If you have any other questions, just let me know. I'm going to add this to the soup again.
Thank you, Ben. He's also a photographer and really good. And if you want your portrait, just ask Ben. We'll get the portrait of you at the protest. Here I am in College Park, Maryland. I drove across the country to protest the FDA, to demand it in person. I hope the FDA is listening. I know they've been coming out. We kind of have like the vortex energy coming off right in this corner. But anyone else want to come up and say a few words? It's an open mic. I want to encourage you every so often. Otherwise, we'll put the music back on. The soup is timed to be served between 12 and 1.